नमस्कार, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर अभिजीत घोष, डायरेक्टर ऑफ व्यासा कोलकाता एंड सेक्रेटरी टू IYA वेस्ट बंगाल चैप्टर। आई एम थैंकफुल टू विश्व भारती योगा डिपार्टमेंट फॉर इन्वाइटिंग मी टू दिस वेबिनार। माई टॉपिक इज इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच ऑफ योगा थेरापी फॉर एसेंशियल हाइपरटेंशन, एसेंशियल आर्टेरियल हाइपरटेंशन। माई एम ऑफ द स्टडी वॉज टू सी टू असेस द इफेक्ट ऑफ शॉर्ट टर्म इंटेंसिव रेसिडेंशियल प्रोग्राम ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच ऑफ योगा थेरापी इन पेशेंट विथ एसेंशियल हाइपरटेंशन। मेथड वॉज to select hypertensive patients, around 154 patients were selected, those who are going through essential hypertension special technique courses in Aragyadham of Vyasa Bangalore campus. My design of the study was pre-post study. It was 2 week of yoga interventional program and the participants were selected, all cases of essential hypertension above the age of 18 years, and they are registered for 2 weeks of IYT yoga program. And the exclusion criteria was those who are having severe hypertension and some kind of other diseases, which is like coronary artery disease, chronic pain and HIV etc. were excluded from the program. This study was done under the continuous observation and monitoring by a team of medical doctors and yoga therapists in the campus. All patients went through a daily routine that included all practices of IYT throughout the day from 5 a.m. till 9:30 p.m. They had yogic, simple, wholesome vegetarian meals, diet with minimum salt, no coffee, tea were given. Even in the campus, there was no TV, radio, etc. to maintain their mental balance. As all of you know, essential arterial hypertension is a kind of pandemic, you can say. Hypertension is a serious global public health problem. Millions of people worldwide suffering from hypertension and morbidity also very high in such cases. Essential hypertension is defined as 3 or more blood pressure reading taken over 3 visits separated by weeks whose average exceeds 140 mmHg systolic blood pressure and 90 is diastolic blood pressure. The prevalence of hypertension is important risk factor for cardiovascular disease. The number of factors increase BP like obesity, insulin resistance, high alcohol intake, high salt intake, aging is one of the major factor, sedentary lifestyle, which is more complicated issue in today's world, and Stress being the root cause of all causes. We may think that in such cases, that's what we say, if this lifestyle disorders or lifestyle related diseases are called psychosomatic ailments. So in psychosomatic ailments, all the ailments, the root cause is stress, and that is our conclusion, that stress is working behind all the diseases. So we need to take care of stress. Low potassium intake, low calcium intake, these all are the issues affecting hypertensive patients. So as stress is taken the root cause for all these psychosomatic ailments, and hypertension or arterial hypertension is one of the major cause, so we need to understand stress. And what is stress according to yogic philosophy? In yogic philosophy, it defines stress. stress is like uncontrolled speed in the mind, this uncontrolled thoughts. And in today's world, to release those uncontrolled thought or stresses, we go for several other methods which gives temporary release of the stress or temporary pleasure which brings hazards in our life, as we witness every day in our life. Not only that, these habits like taking coffee, cigarette, alcohol, this all kind of habits makes our next generation vulnerable. So that's what we need to think it, and we need to choose the path in which way the stress can be tackled and all kind of psychosomatic ailments can be managed or cured through other methods. All kind of stress related symptoms, if we see, the symptoms will have alarming effects, so that we need to understand the stress is working and it leads to somewhere where people will be suffering from various ailments. In the very beginning, in stage 1, we can see all the symptoms, it will be reflected on the Manomaya Kosha in mental level, in the form of insomnia, restlessness, irritability, indecisiveness, emotional outburst, depression, anxiety, all kind of thing it will reflect in our day-to-day life. So that's what, when this alarm comes, we need to understand we are under stress and we need attention. So that's what the management of this kind of situation or pre-hypertensive situation, the management through integrated approach of yoga therapy, we can see the solution for all kind of psychosomatic ailments too. And the therapy we give in IAYT, the basis of this therapy is the module of Panchakosha. In Taittiriya Upanishad, the method is given categorically, and they say this human body, this existence of life, is not a single body. We are combined with many other facets, which is called Panchakosha. The basic which we can see as a physical body, it is called Annamaya Kosha. Then we have the prana body, the energy body. Then we have the mind, Manomaya Kosha. Then intellect, the Vijnanamaya Kosha. Then at the end we can see, it is explained, it is called Anandamaya Kosha, the blissful existence of our life. But in this 5 layer of existence, where the stress is taking place, that we need to understand. Here, the Manomaya Kosha and Vijnanamaya Kosha, the conflict between these two thoughts, conflict between these two mind, this is the root cause of all kind of conflicts and stress. And yoga interventions, that's what, to cope up with this stress or to release those stress from mind, in yoga IAYT approach, we have several different kind of techniques to release those stress. IAYT developed on our understanding and research according to yoga scriptures and pathophysiology of hypertension, included physical practices of kriyas, the cleaning techniques, which is available in Hatha Yoga, yoga asanas, the special techniques for hypertension, pranayama, the special breathing technique, very ancient technique, meditation, different meditation to calm down the mind, lectures on yoga philosophy to understand the purpose of life and the facet of our action in our day-to-day life. Yogic counseling, which is another most important style of counseling, and which is based on Bhagavad Gita and other yogic scriptures to understand life better. And yoga therapy is given in a module based on Panchakosha theory. So in physical level, we give the practices of asanas to purify the physical body internally and externally. We give kriyas, we have diet and herbal medicines to take care of regular problems. Then for the vital energy body, for the pranamaya kosha, we have the technique of pranayama, breathing techniques. For the mind, Manomaya Kosha, we have dharana, dhyana practices, where the emotion culture we have in bhajan sessions to take care of those emotions which comes in our mind and disturbs our whole life. So that's what the Manomaya Kosha is very important, and those techniques are given in Manomaya Kosha. We need to practice very carefully. Then for Vijnanamaya, for the intellectual sheets, we have notional correction, need to understand our problem, and happiness analysis. Why we are losing our happiness? Why this disorder in our day-to-day life is happening? Need to understand, need to analyze those thoughts. Which thoughts are giving this trouble? So that's what, in this way, till Anandamaya Kosha, for the happiness body, for the blissful existence, we need to practice Karma Yoga, action in bliss, action in relaxation. Those theories are given in Karma Yoga theory in Ananda Mimamsa. And to understand the happiness and to understand the deeper blissful existence of our life through proper understanding, through learning our scriptures, etc. In the practical session, we shall demonstrate and see the practical aspect of all the things explained in our IUIT approach. And what we saw after 2 weeks of intervention with our patients, tremendous improvement in all the categories of parameters whatever we have chosen, and mostly we saw this age group from 18 and above age group was taken for the IUIT research protocol. There we saw all such kind of parameters has tremendous reduction, including medication scores. So outcome measures were taken like blood pressure, respiratory rate, breath holding time, weight reduction, general health questionnaire, and Triguna questionnaires. These were the parameters what we have taken, and really it was amazing to see the, all the points has given the p-value is 0.001, is beautiful result. And the personality measures like sattva, rajas, tamas, they are also in that area what we say in yogic texts. So tremendous improvement in those things. Special findings, if we think some special literature review we have gone through, there we saw the restoration of baroreflex sensitivity to normal level, a yoga posture called Viparit Karani. It was found that head tilt inverted posture that was included in this special technique. It is suggested that the essential hypertension could be cured or controlled by this posture. The research was done by Selvamurthy ji, and really it is inspiring. And the conclusion, the current investigation found that the IUIT intervention is beneficial to patients with essential hypertension within a short period of 2 weeks. Higher the baseline blood pressure, greater was the degree of reduction in blood pressure. That is very most important to see the result. IUIT reduces the pulse rate, respiratory rate, and blood pressure in hypertensive, indicating the stress-reducing effect of yoga. IUIT reduces antihypertensive medication requirement of hypertensives. It improves general health, lung capacity, which is most important in today's COVID-19 situation. To improve our lung capacity, to strengthen our breathing pattern, to strengthen our breath holding capacity, and other practices which improves our immune system. That's what this practice is taken care of essential hypertension, at the same time to other variety type of problem were taken care by these practices. Increase of sattvic personality, characteristic of tamasic personality was gone down. These are the beautiful results we could see in this research project. Tremendous result we could see, especially the respiratory rate decreased by 10% after the 2 week of practice. Not only that, this Bhramari time, the breath holding time, was improved beautifully, like 34% increased in breath holding time, which is another another path-breaking practices for IOIT program, which can influence this COVID-19 situation also to practice in this pandemic. Suggestion for future research, what we observe, a similar design with randomized control design is suggested, if somebody can do, and future studies may focus on other variables that would throw light on mechanism such as autonomic function, studies biochemical and molecular measures of stress. That will give another dimension in the field of yoga research. Hope near future people will do more better and deeper research in the field of hypertension, especially essential hypertension, and to take care of this today's world and the future of today, so that the future is for yoga, future is for lifestyle approach, that we need to think and to promote yoga in a such a way so that whole world is practicing yoga and maintaining good health with fresh mind. Thank you very much. Namaskar.